Here's our example class again. Now let's look at the middle compartment, which is for purposes of describing attributes. You'll see that there are different attributes described. All of them have names, they have types, and they may have some other symbols that describe how the names can be accessed from other classes. Those symbols describe the visibility of that name. They're optional. You don't have to provide them, and there's no reason at the start to do that. They're a refinement which you add later on in the process. The four options in UML for visibility include publicly visible, that's a plus sign, private, which is a minus sign, protected, meaning that only subclasses can access that attribute, is the pound sign, and for those situations where you've used UML packages, the tilde indicates that the name is visible within the package. In addition to the visibility, of course, you must have the name of the attribute. You can indicate the multiplicity and ordering of the attribute. Now, they're not shown in this example, but we'll see them later. You should give the type of the attribute, and UML has a set of built-in types that you can use. You can optionally describe an initial value for that particular instance variable. You can indicate that the instance variable is derived, that is, it's computed rather than being set directly. And you can give some additional properties to the instance variable using the braces notation that we mentioned before. For example, we can indicate that that particular instance variable is frozen. That means its value can't change.